Hey guys, it's the Squid here, and welcome to the review of the Star Wars Bandai Model Kit ATM6. And if you want to see the unboxing video, there will be some video links at the end of the video. You can just click on that to watch the unboxing video if you want, or you can exit this video to check out the unboxing. But if not, as you can see, it is pretty empty. I finished putting together the kit. Pretty simple build. So you can see just all empty runners there. So let's just chuck those in and have a look at the ATM6 real quick. This review will be quite short since, you know, the ATM6 kit isn't that huge or anything. It is relatively simple. So here's the ATM6 in its after it's built. Of course, I did some paint jobs. If not, it's completely grey. I painted the visor there red with some red Gundam marker. Not that clean, but at least I got some color in there. Not too bad. also went over some areas with silver. These parts at the top here went over with some silver. Let me just adjust the light so you can see that. So you can see some bits of silver at the top there. The legs, I went over these circular parts with some silver. Silver. This part is silver as well. Of course, I painted the inside of the legs as well. I'm not gonna just paint one side. The back of the rear legs, I've got this part silver, this part silver, this part silver, the little piston there, silver. These parts on the feet, silver as well. So overall, not too bad. The bottom, I got that little round bit painted silver. And the back, that little bit there, silver as well. The turret at the top is also mostly silver. The neck, I've got some silver sections there. For the head, I've got some silver at the top, silver at the sides, and then got some silver there, and some silver in there. It's a bit hard to see, but yeah, those are all the areas I painted. Of course, if you do not want to paint this kit, it's perfectly fine as well, just that it will look a bit bland. Of course, if you wanted to, you could also do some panel lining. I did not panel line this kit, because that's just way too many lines for me to go over, and I was feeling kind of lazy. So anyways, for articulation, this kit does have a ball joint that's way in there. As you can see, it's all the way in there, so it can do some slight up and downs, very slight, side to side, nothing at all. And then it can rotate like that. It pops off sometimes. You can see there's the ball joint, so you may want to glue that in. I don't see the point of, you know, turning the head around. Not much point in that. Legs, they do go out like that. As you can see, I think the other side moves out more, because this one gets stopped by, as you can see, there's this latch at the side here that kind of blocks movement, and it does pop out pretty easily. So whereas the other side does not have anything, so it can go all the way up and stuff. So movement on one side is better than the other. As for the rear legs, they're connected at this section, so they do move in a weird way like that. It's kind of odd, but you know, this all the way back, then front, back, front, back. So the mid sections do not bend at all, so you're not going to get any super expressive poses. At most, you're just going to like put one foot forward like so, just one foot slightly forward. Make it look like as if it's walking, and that's about all the articulation you get. As for the build quality, the build was pretty fun. There are some really tiny parts you have to look out for, like the turret here is super tiny. I almost lost that piece. If not, the rest, not many tiny pieces. The side guns are also pretty small, so you may want to look out for those. If not, most of the chunks are huge chunks. This is like one huge chunk and all that stuff, so pretty simple to put together. Detail-wise, there is a lot of detail, like I said in the unboxing video. As you can see, it's just detail everywhere. If you did a full detail job, it will probably look super nice. So, do I think you should get this kit? Well, it's really up to you. If you enjoy Star Wars, if you like The Last Jedi, enjoyed the Battle of Crait, well, I'd say get this, because this is relatively cheap kit. It's like, what, 600 yen? I know I'm holding the box up to them, but 600 yen. So it's pretty cheap, and detail is excellent. It's not like one of those, it's not like SD Gundams where there's barely any detail on them. These have much more detail, super cool, impressive. Though articulation is a bit limited, but you know, these things aren't meant to have so much. I mean, if you want something with a lot of articulation, get the Edit Walker, the bigger scale Edit Walker. So yeah, so now my plans for this kit is to probably build a small crate diorama. As you can see in the box here, there is crate in the background with the red smoke popping everywhere. So I may build one. The base will probably be about this size. If I have the space, I would probably make a few small crate speeders using probably cardboard, nothing too fancy. Just cut and all that, cut the shapes, glue them together, paint them a bit. And then for the smoke, I'll probably use cotton wool painted red. And yeah, if I do plan to do the diorama, yeah, you guys will see videos on it. But if not, guys, that's about it for this video. And this is the squid blooping off.